Welcome back, everyone. We finally figured out where we're supposed to go. This whole time.
Snapple right there.
What was it? We went to...
Oh yeah, it took us... What? Two and a half days to find this?
I just need to wander around a little bit. I know we went somewhere that was like off a cliff almost.
Yeah, we went somewhere that looked similar to this.
Oh.
Ooh, hey, watch out. Shit. They've got the giant bows.
Shit!
You gonna get fucked, mate. Ah. Oh, bruh. You gonna... God damn it! There's two of them! 1 minute into the episode! Again!
You're making it tradition now to just die right off the bat when you start an episode.
Oh yeah, I also did find the bonfire.
Wait. Go to that giant Lord Wood statue.
Just like
it's
okay.
Hit it.
Oh.
Nothing.
Could have sworn there was something back there.
Nope.
I don't know. There's something back there in Dark Souls 3. I figured.
But oh yeah, the chest across the platform there.
Which chest?
The one near the lady statue. Across the lady statue.
Yeah.
You know where her feet are?
Yeah.
If you jump onto the platform that has her feet, you can walk off into that small other area. That's what that small crevice when you go down the stairs is for. You can jump in between them if you go by her feet. So you go up top, you jump down to her feet, you'd walk across, and you can either roll or you can run jump. Further run jump, that way you know you make it in, but you just go through the bars, you don't jump down.
That's what it's for. Okay. That makes more sense.
What happens when I test stuff?
You're gonna like the boss. How I enjoy the clusterfuck bosses because they're just really fun for me.
Somewhat.
The Abyss Watchers. Or, yeah, they were the Abyss Watchers, right?
I don't know.
The pointy hat guys.
Come for me, the other one back off. One more hit. There we go. I think they've gotten tougher since last time I fought them. Ow!
The giant cloud stripe sword, I believe, is in this. Usually, there's a lot of swords that carry over the first game into all three games. Like the Washington.
Oh,
Washington is very nice.
Bye.
Okay, bye bye.
Thank you. Okay. Back down here we go. Start it when I get back there, but I'm not gonna have them watch me walk my ass back there again.
You should.
No.
That's everybody should enjoy this adventure. Because I'm certainly enjoying this adventure. No. Because I'm not playing it.
I know you're not.
Because I already beat it, and it took me 60 plus hours.
This also has me MIA at the moment, so. Yep. Every time I just said fuck.
You know, Anamondo looks so much better in the summer than it does in the winter.
I was hoping I could send it down.
Nope.
You almost got sent flying off the edge.
I hope you guys like that one, because I will add that. Almost
fucking
threw me off an edge.
You didn't even get hurt, you were just thrown into near oblivion.
Okay, bye. And welcome back, everyone.
Except there wasn't any welcome back. We pretty much lost the way back because of that fucker.
Oh no. Fuck!
Dude, you're getting really fucked.
Oh! Oh
you should have drank your Sunny D instead of going
6,000. Souls!
That greedy fucker. You could have survived that.
Yeah, but normally when I drink my fucking Sunny D, that's when they kill me.
They were far enough away! I don't want to hear shit.
Yeah. Yes, I do. Makes everyone's range of aggro shorter. It's what you get from the cat when you get someone 3 times to win successfully. It's in that giant door.
Oh, the invasion doors. That's yes. Like the biggest PvP area.
Yep. And I will tell you right now, even for Dark Souls 1, it's very hard getting people to fight you. There's not fucking 3 other people. What the fuck?
Yeah. That happens a lot.
Somewhere I miss. I can just fuck them. Fucking souls.
I like that I can see the aggro range because you're floating.
I thought that was just the light that
I'm pretty sure that's just the aggro range.
From the top.
And from the bottom.
Fuck.
Drank your Sunny D at a stupid time. They were both swinging at you, and you were like, hang on, guys. Let me take a drink. This is hefty work. They both swung, and you took a drink right in the middle of their swing.
I had
Did
no
you
choice.
Expect to survive?
Yes!
That's not how that works. You roll out of the way, and then take a drink.
I couldn't roll, because then I would have rolled to the other guy, and he would have hit me, and I would have died.
Roll me back. You were in a position where you could roll in between them out of the way.
Roll me back.
You're so bad. Why do you do this?
Because I've never played this game before.
There is no will be back. Half of this content we're gonna have to come to because we're actually talking for once.
Maybe I'll just leave it in.
You should!
Fine.
Fuck you!
When and where, bitch?
You're already getting fucked. I don't have time to.
Yes, you do. Might as well make it a three-way. Oh, wait, it's already a three-way. Let's make it a four-way, because we're fucking Archer.
It's already a, like, six-way, Justin.
Shit.
There's no fucking room for me.
Who are the other two?
This guy! He counts as two people. He's definitely trying to get in on the mission. And this guy, he's just... You just turn around and fuck him. And then this guy.
Fuck you.
See ya. You keep getting fucked from all sides.
Oh my god! Where you fucking stop?
Jumping motherfucker.
Die!
He's a jumping fool.
Oh my god! Just, nope. Coming out. Nope.
This is why you have problems.
Why haven't you worked? I'm gonna say no because I think I solved them all. Probably, because I do.
So the one time I actually need one.
Does that bring these guys in? The super projectile's gonna be handy. Oh yeah, that's gonna do a lot. Oh yeah. Oh! Cheap him out. Okay, now you're getting cocky, and I don't feel bad for you. You deserve death.
I swung and I didn't look at my health first. How the fuck do I make it past those guys?
You run. Like the little baby you are.
Where do I run to?
You just run.
Which way?
Just fucking run!
Where
does it look? There's one way to run. Just run. Don't ask dumb questions. You're gonna get dumb answers.
There's a window!
Fucking run!
There's a window?
Run! You're gonna get shot!
Where do I go? Right or left?
Just run!
Okay!
Right or left is your decision.
Going right!
Oh. Ow!
This is painful! Oh!
You fucking idiot! No, I'm an idiot. I'm not gonna run when you want.
Because I got shot! And I can't run!
But just because you got a giant spear up your ass doesn't mean you can't run. I've seen plenty of people do it.
Okay, I know where I should have a giant spear up your ass. And
I've
got
a giant spear up my ass.
Well, you're gonna have two now. No, we're gonna get six, because right now I'm doing six motherfuckers.
Maybe if you weren't so terrible, this wouldn't be happening to you.
I can't handle six!
That's not my problem!
It's my problem because I'm tearing me a new one!
Is this a PDA?
No, it's a calculator. It's a
what? What the hell? This looks like a PDA that you just like. Why do you have a calculator that looks like this? It almost looks like a makeup case.
Because it doesn't die. You just got like this little pocket flip calculator. Because one, I have yet to ever have to put the batteries in that. And two, I use it for work. Yeah. But it's indoors.
It's so powered.
When is it sitting in the sun?
Never. I don't know. When are you sitting in the sun?
Never. I work night shift. I don't get the lunch sitting in the sun.
Well, maybe you should try it.
Maybe when there's not fucking snow on the ground.
You know, you're mostly invisible, and you had no depth perception for your weapon anyways, and this is just making it worse.
No, but it's also the fact that I'm so used to giant long weapons.
That's why I had so much trouble being a sorcerer in Dark Souls 3, because it was just... I'm not allowed to hit things, I have to cast magic spells. Did he just throw shit at you?
Yep.
Souls.
I'm gonna die.
Yeah, you always do. It's without fail.
Okay, so
I will see you in the next episode.
Bye.
Bye.